Did you say you want a naked woman tattoo?
Starship Enterprise.
What are you gonna get?
I would put a tattoo, but it'd have to come along. It'd have to be like a henna. It'd have to be temporary.
So
it doesn't have a. I change my mind too often. Suppose I change my mind and it's like, I don't like it anymore. And you're stuck with it. Or you put a girl's name on there and she dumps you. Then you got a girl's name on it.
Well, if you truly love her, then it doesn't matter.
Hey, but if she dumps you, how could you have your name on her?
Well, you remember that you were in love.
Well, true love lasts forever.
Exactly, so then you should never regret it.
But you fall out of love at one side, well, then it's not true love. What is it then? Infatuation? Chemical attraction? What is it? I was in love once, and the person I thought I was in love with, I guess I really didn't know her.
But you are in love with her, so you still think about her.
Or the person I was in love with actually really never existed. So it was a lie. It was an image in my head, and that person was not that person. It wasn't real. It was an illusion.
You were doing bad things behind the girl's back.
Yes and no.
More than likely, one of your friends tattled on.
That's a possibility,
but I don't know. You should contact her. That'd be so romantic.
I think she grew out of me.
So you should still try to hook up. You still think of her.
She's probably a different person. She's probably old and fat now.
You still think of her. Why are you trying?
I think of the girl that I knew a long time ago. That person probably doesn't exist.
What if and she's I don't
know if that person really ever existed.
Sure it did.
She was an illusion. Star Trek.
You could rekindle it. And then have a total fantasy.
And then the illusion went away and she thought, she gets all like that.
Well, one good thing is you're the same person always. Never changed.
That's what my friend Frank's father said. Because his son changed. Kind of did a dig at him. He goes, Greg, you'll never
change. Is that okay, or do you want him more?
That's good.
All
just
right.
Some more butter. So things with the friendship with Sandy or friendship with Bob. When you look back and you remember and you're outside of yourself, you're not in the middle of it, Paul especially, you realize that, don't put that online.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I know too.
Where
do the dance.
With the Manson people and all these things. Which didn't happen.
Make them laugh so hard.
Eric likes Saturday Night Live. He's playing nice.
Scarface.
Really?
Chuck Berry.
Really?
Yeah. Little Richard. Bo Diddley.
That's a moment in history.
Yeah.
That's a real moment in history.
The Twist guy.
Where was
Chuck,
it?
Chubby Checker.
Chubby Checker.
Remember in kindergarten, it was, do the twist. We were doing the twist in kindergarten.
Mm-hmm.
Do the twist.
It's like Radio City Music.
They used to have a lot of acts
and
like that.
Chuck Berry came out with the guitar. And
they had acts like that. They had a lot of acts like that. Would go to Palo Cities Music Park in the summertime.
I remember that place. That was great.
Yeah, but I remember that. I was like, that was great. Little Richard, too. I was like, wow.
You saw Little Richard?
My favorite homosexual musician of all time.
Little Richard.
Yes.
Who doesn't?
I guess he is gay.
He is. Jerry Lee Lewis, too, was there.
He's great.
I love.
I like what Little Richard said. It was everybody rock and roll. All I did was sway.
I know him from Pee Wee. Hi, Pee Wee.
I like when he made a comeback in the 80s.
He goes on the ice.
He's doing those funny commercials with Dr. Joyce Brothers.
He's doing a movie.
And he used to go like, "Oh, Richard."
I loved him.
And then there's that scary Mother Goose movie. Have you seen that? Have you seen the scary Mother Goose movie?
I think he was in the movie Down and Out in Beverly Hills, whatever hell that was.
Yeah. He's been a lot. He did a lot of cameos
for the Washington Monument and Journal in the Village. And he goes, "I'm from the future." And he goes, he's sitting there. And they did some really funny gags. And like the two homosexual guys are in the thing. He goes, "Homosexuality is accepted in the future because of all the population. And people just accept it." And I goes, "Oh, thank you." And the gay guy goes, over and goes, "Hey, get away." And then he goes, Arthur Dietrich comes in. You know, the guy who's always the know-it-all. He goes, "You're Arthur Dietrich? You're the famous Arthur. Let me shake your hand." The black guy goes, "Oh, come on." The one with pot was funny. When they found the pot, they were eating the pot. They didn't know it. And Fish ate it. And he became like super cop. He chased the guy.
No, I don't remember.
He goes, he jumped over over 50 feet off a roof after me. And he goes, like, I throws him down, and Fish is like, "Get in there, you scum!" And everybody's like, "What's happening to Fish?" You know, they found this like all these bakeable cookies somewhere, and the rat ate it, and the rat like went nuts. They said the rat started attacking me. All the ones with the celebrities, one with John Wayne. They had the one with Superman with George Reeves. That was hysterical. Did you ever see that one? Yeah. For Little Ricky's birthday party, they needed to get Superman.
Superman.
And she goes out, she pretends she's Superman. "Do you have cape problems?" He goes, "This is a cape is stuck on the drain."
Yeah, she goes out on the ledge. Right?
Yeah. And he's yelling, Ricky's, "I want to know what you're doing out there. And 25 years of married." He goes, wait a minute. "You were married to her for 25 years? He goes, "Yes." He goes, "And they call me Superman." He pushes the piano out of the way. He's like, "Pushes." That was a good one. They colorized that one, too. They made it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I bought the DVD of it.
I remember the one with Harpo Marx. It was cute.
That was good. The one with...
Vitamin Vitamin was great.
That was on recently, too.
I say that all the time. Yeah.
Bob has the figure. It's like a
okay, cool.
Blue, tired, listless, poop out of parties.
That one with John Wayne, which was hysterical. She broke the... She broke his thing on the Hollywood Walk of Fame on Graham's Chinese, his footprints. So I had to make a new one, and he's trying to do it, and she pushes the whole thing in his face.
See, when I was little, I didn't like the ones with celebrities because I didn't know who they were. Maybe
that's something.
She was a genius.
Oh, she was.
You know, if it wasn't for her, you wouldn't have Star Trek.
Nope, you would not have Star Trek.
Desi Lu Studios.
They wanted to drop it, and they CBS didn't want it. She, some reason, she liked Gene Roddenberry. She goes, "I have faith in him." And Ricky wasn't crazy about it. "Ah, it caused us a lot of trouble, censors." And then he turned around. You know who broke up their marriage?
Well, she was cheating all the time.
You know who broke up their marriage?
What?
Barbara Eden. The last part of the show, she was on it. That was the straw that broke the camel's back. She started going out. She was on the show. She used to fuck around at the Vegas. He fucked around with her, Ricky Ricardo, with Desi Arnaz. He fucked around with her on the show. And she was known in Hollywood as breaking
up. Oh, Dream of Genie?
Yes. She was on. She was very young. She was just starlet.
You talking about Genie?
Yeah.
I was going to say that's one of my favorite shows when I was little. It was Genie.
Well, he's a good-looking Cuban man. He's a handsome guy.
Lucy, my father used to look exactly like him when he was young. My mom, he used to cheat on my mom. And my mom used to look like that. I see pictures of him. He looked like a little bit taller.
He's a good-looking guy, and he's famous.
He used to tell me, he goes, "Yeah, she's funny, but he really makes that show." I go, "Well, how come, Pop?" And my mother goes, "Because he thinks he looks like him."
Yeah, no, I mean, Lucy came
out. She was in the Three Stooges short when she first started out.
She did a lot of shit. She did stuff with Red Skelton.
Well, she came out later in life and talked about how Ricky, you know, well, how much her husband cheated on her and hurt her, and, you know.
They came to an agreement in the end. They were friends in the end.
Yeah.
I never understood in the show why he wouldn't let her go on the show.
Well, it was the whole thing. It was the thing. She was always a troublemaker, and she would make...
But the only reason she was is because he wouldn't let her in the show.
Yeah, but she would screw up.
Yeah.
If he would just...
Like she did the candy factory.
If he would have just put Karen to, like, show and teaching her what to do, then there would be no trouble.
This is like watching you do effects is like watching Lucy do it. It's like an island
Lucy.
That's
what he meant by Susan, is that he's the Lucy of effects. That's what he would say about you. He's,
yeah,
he's
he told
the,
me
I
that.
I love Lucy of makeup effects, of animatronics, whatever. I'm like, what? You know Lucy, you know, she means well, and she does okay, but she screws everything up.
Wasn't she the first?
Yeah. Who fucked up the servos? Got me all those red servos, cost a fortune. Didn't have to be that high tech. Have to have those red servos. Even the guy from Rama's Hobby goes, you're going to spend a fortune on these
No,
German
the problem
servos.
With they were new. They were the new flavor of the month, these servos. And everybody's using them in California. The only problem is the they were metal. They weren't plastic.
They're gear, yeah.
The
There's
gear
no
inside,
forgiving. There's no forgiving.
Any if you go past a certain torque, they
burn out.
Yeah. And that's what's happening.
I've had regular servos burn out. Because
that's why everything is Futaba, and you're fine.
You know, no, you also
you get those German.
You ones. Also you also have to figure out the throw of the servos because what we're doing.
Well,
is,
he figured because they're metal, everything that they're stronger.
Yeah, but just burned them out.
But it just burnt out.
Yeah,
they
what
can't
are you
handle motors and radio control stuff.
Paul was right. He overbuilt it. Huh. It was too complicated. It didn't have to be that complicated.
No, he didn't know what he did was brilliant. It was the servos.
I don't know how
they burnt
that Lucy
out.
When
that.
You have a servo, you got it. You got
because how Miles used to say, Greg was the I love Lucy of effects. You know, when Lucy means well, but she fucks everything up.
Didn't she start reruns? Like
she had a bunch of shows.
She no, she started. She did something big.
They had the I Love Lucy show.
Like she like
then
was
they had
the first
one with Ricky
to, like,
and her later. It was after that.
It was
the something Lucy show. And then when Jay got divorced, she had the Lucy show. And then I forgot there was something else that she had after that with her kids. She had a son and her daughter. You know, she
and they were good.
They were good.
Something like
even the color ones.
She was the first to do something.
She had the banker friend of the guy
Mr. Mooney.
Mr. Mooney.
Yeah. And she had Ethel, Vivian Williams.
Yeah. I remember Fred had a grudge against her because they had a chance to break off and do their own show. And somehow I think Ethel didn't want to do it or something.
Well, they had what's her name? Vivian Leigh had problems with it too because she was like the second.
Ethel
fiddle.
And Fred didn't like each
other. You know. They were second. It's like when I was, you can't put this online.
Why?
Because it's I don't want it getting out there. Take it off. She, what happened was in there was a publicity shot. He goes, Shatner comes in. They were all standing there and they said, you got to be on this spot. You got to be out of focus. You got to be on this spot and be out of focus. Don't record that. So he goes,
why? Are you talking about Star Trek?
No, this is dirt. So he goes, I don't want it to get out. He goes,
well, everything about Shatner's been out and Shatner doesn't give a shit.
So Cody comes to me, he goes, Shatner comes to the thing late. He comes to the thing late, like he walks in, like, you know. And,
I love William
and he pushes,
Shatner.
He starts pushing Walter out of the way. And he goes, Bill, I got to stand here. I got to be on my mark. I'm going to be out of focus. And Shatner looks and goes, who cares if you're out of focus?
Oh, that's funny. It's like, you know, that's great.
And he basically described him. Remember Ted Baxter on the Mary Tyler Moore show?
Yeah.
He described Shatner as being like that.
Well, he is like that.
Yeah. And like,
I worked with him.
I said, This is devastating.
I worked with him.
And then he's like yelling, they're not paying us enough money. They're getting all the big money. And we're not. We didn't get the residuals on the show. And he was sitting there with his drink. He goes, they're bad. They're evil. They're bad. These people at Paramount are bastards. They're, he's like, really, really. He was a nice guy other than that. He was like a really
I worked
nice
with
guy.
Koenig.
Yeah. He said,
you know, the pilot, all the aliens in there?
Yeah.
I wound up being one of, like, the show.
You told me, yeah.
And then they wound up taking all the that footage and using it for something else, and then we did another show.
He had a great role in Babylon 5. He was excellent. He played a real bastard. The psychor cop guy. He was, like, really good. Paul Ellison was in that show, too. They had a cameo with him in it. And, played this guy Bester. That's what
I worked with all the Star Trek stars.
I know. You didn't want to tell Shatner I worked on 5.
Well, you weren't around. You were at home in Jersey dealing with Bob.
I met him once, but it was like at a mall thing where he was signing shit.
Andy Clements, his father-in-law.
Hi, life. It was fun to watch.
I remember when people would go up to him on set because I did his monsters. He's like, wait, we have practical monsters? I was like, yeah. He goes, oh, I thought they were going to be see. Oh, I didn't know this. They started taking pictures of the monsters
I'm
I made.
I'm angry for you for that. And I'm angry for you that you have the Christopher Plummer Bird of Prey.
Why? It's in the same office.
I can't find it anywhere. I think I can find it.
That is like yours. It's in the same
release
room.
Release the one of my favorite lines. Used to, release the dogs of war. Yeah, that's a great one. I prefer Shakespeare in its original Klingon. He has a little. He had the. Everybody was making fun of that. He had the patch, and it was like, it was screwed in.
Bolted in his head.
Christopher Plummer was a great actor too. He was a good actor. Both Canadians.
You guys are really nerdy.
Yeah. Yes, we are. I am a king of the nerds.
He just died too, Christopher Plummer.
Oh no! Really?
Yeah.
Damn.
About 9 months ago. They're all going. Everybody gets great. It's going. Yeah,
that sucks. Somebody else died recently. I forgot who. Yeah,
David Bowie.
David Bowie died a while ago.
Prince. All the good ones. Huey Lewis's voice went.
He's got big fan of his, man, in the 80s.
Yeah, his voice went.
His voice went?
Yeah, some problem, yeah, and I can't sing anymore.
That's Meatloaf. He had a problem, too, but he said it was psychological. He had, like, some problem with his voice. I don't know what happened to him.
What a nice guy. I worked with him on
Meatloaf,
Monsters.
Yeah. He used to play softball, of course, in my girlfriend's building. I used to see him all the time. I said, hey, Loaf. He's like,
hey, yep. Loaf.
Yeah, I go, hey, Loaf. He's way back. And I saw Billy Idol at a Trek convention, at a creation convention. Everybody went into the auditorium to see somebody, and he went in the dealer's room when nobody was there, and I happened to be there, and he's walking around, and I said, "That's Billy Idol," and I went, and I said, "Hey, Billy, Rebel Yell," he went, "Hi," you know, like that.
Really?
Yeah.
He was that cool.
He was. Oh yeah, he was cool. He was cool.
You know, he hears it all the time. And then, still have that nice of a reaction.
And
that's nice.
I first met. Luke,
Mark
Hamill, years and years ago at a convention, he was buying like videotapes, and he was looking for like the pilot for the Munsters, and I told him where he had. Oh yeah, is this a good price for this? I said, yeah, it's a decent price. He was asking me, is this a good? Because I think he was afraid people were going to overcharge him, you know. And he told me that he went to the comic book convention when and he went there when Star Wars.
Oh, sushi girl, we talked.
He got trouble. Yeah, I talked to him at night. He kept calling me Gary.
Hey, Gary.
The other one was Don from Lost in Space was cool. Jonathan Harris was cool. And Yvonne Craig was really cool. She was a Batgirl. She was really
You're one of my favorite celebrities I ever met, Greg.
Oh, yeah. I'm not a celebrity. Don't put me
on. We're talking about celebrities. Why aren't we talking about you?
I met Linda Hamilton from Planet of the Apes. She was at. I'm sorry, my brain.
Oh, you mean Nova?
Nova.
Linda Harrison.
Linda
yeah.
Harrison.
Yeah, I met her too. I met her just briefly with her.
She was older, but I remember I was like, I just looked out. I was just like, you have no idea what I feel about you.
I saw her like years later. She still looked good.
She's gorgeous. Even as an old lady.
The one that one show, I was at a show and I was standing with Bob and Sandy. 70s. And I saw Erin Gray and she was walking and she had the tight outfit on and I'm looking at her. And I just said, it's Erin Gray. And she still looks really hot. And she turned around, she looked at me, she went, and she smiled. And I was so embarrassed. And she took it as a compliment. I thought that was so cool.
Well, of course.
Most ladies, they stay thin and they take care of themselves. And when they get in their 60s, they still look great.
Adam West was a little bit of a shit when I met him. But he
turned
to be
cool. He's always weird. He's a weird guy.
Who's Adam West?
Batman, the original Batman. Hmm. He would charge like money for. I was selling photos, and he would get his. He would send his. He had, I forget the guy's name, Bill or something. His name.
You know what's weird? Kamal told me one time.
Yeah.
He said that he met Batman and Robin. He said at the movie theater in Jersey City, and I go.
Yeah, I was there in Jersey City when I was a kid.
My father had me on my shoulders.
You were there? I was there too when they came for the
movie.
When they did the
yeah,
you were there?
I was there.
They came late.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, I remember we were waiting a long time.
Yeah. My mom took me. She was so mad she took me. Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, no worries.
You want me to pay this here?
Yeah, you can pay it here because they're going to close the register over there. Yeah.
Oh, you guys are shutting down.
Cute. 12 o'clock they close.
Yeah, I know.
It used to be 24 hours, right?
Yeah, but the whole pandemic happened.
Oh, yeah. That's so good. It was at the Lowy's.
Yeah. Jersey City.
Yeah. You were there?
Yeah.
That's weird. I couldn't see Batman and Robin. My father picked me up, put me on his shoulders.
That's how I put the tip on there. I don't know if it'll
be. Oh, no problem. Just remove your card.
Do we give her a tip, or was it like
yeah, I tried to check and see if you guys...
No problem.
Yeah, if you get $2, you'll know.
No, I do
20%. No problem. You're all set, sir. Thank you
okay.
so much.
Thank you.
Yeah, you can keep
thank
that. You. Thank you, guys. Have a good night.
No, because I had a...
I remember that. I was like, I can't see, Dad. I can't see. Because there was a whole big crowd because they were
waiting. They stopped the movie. They came late.
Yeah, yeah. And they stopped late. And my father goes... And I remember the whole thing. My father picking me up. And put me on his shoulders and them coming out of the car.
This is
and they ran
this is
in,
a story. You know? Years and years, flash forward, years and years later, I'm selling photos at a convention.
Kamal was there.
I'm selling photos at a convention. Adam West sends his agent.
Yeah, weird guy.
That weird guy. And he goes, oh, you shouldn't sell these and this and that. And I went up to him and I went to Adam West. I said, look, I'm making pocket money selling this stuff. And I had he had like shitty stuff. I had like really good stuff from the TV show. He had stuff he did like in the 80s when he dressed up as Batman. And I'm sitting there and Yvonne, I think the guy was named Adam, I think, or something. And that was his agent.
Well, where'd you get all these photos from?
I bought a collection from a guy of negatives. And that's why I used to go shows and make money.
Them, yeah.
I printed them myself. I wasn't supposed to. It wasn't legal. So anyway, I went. I had a guy from 20th Century Fox come, and they were looking at my stuff, and they said because I'd lost space, Voyage of the Sea and stuff. And they said, you know, they let it go because it was old, you know. And I started supplying Mark Garter, Don, his photos, and then Bill Mummy contacted me, and then Jonathan Harris, and I was giving all the photos, and then. I remember I had this one photo of Judy, I forget her name, the girl played Judy on Lost in Space. She did when she was really young, she did a surfboard commercial. And I had her with the surfboard, and she's in a really, really skippy bikini. And Don, you know, Mark Gardner, Don, holds it up to her at a show. He goes, look at this, look what I got. And she goes, when did you get that? And he goes, he got it from him. And she goes, oh, she was like looking at me. She went like that. But anyway, so I'm selling the photos.
Judy was so pretty.
Yeah. She was
beautiful. Girl.
So Adam West sends the guy beautiful over, and he's being kind of a dick to me. This is a really funny story. So sitting there, and Yvonne Craig goes, "I saw what happened." He goes, Adam and Bill are being like, they're trying to bad cop, good cop. They're trying to do a deal on you. And I looked at she came over, and I said, "Look," and Bob was there. I said, "Look, being the years, I said I followed your career. You were an our man Flint, in like Flint. I said you were in that Star Trek episode. I always thought you were very attractive." She was, I will let you have any photos on this, as many as you want. You can take photos of yours. And she goes, oh, thank you. I'll just take a couple. And she took a couple. And we had a long talk. And then she saw a thing of Shatner, and she goes, she started stabbing it. She goes, I go, why? She goes, he's just like Adam. Both of them are the same. She goes, they both wanted to get into my pants. That's all they wanted was to get into my pants. And she goes, and Shatner, she goes, and Bill, he did two things. He would always want to get into the actress's pants, and he always told the director how to direct. He's an impossible man. He's impossible to get. I want to hear these stories. You know, so we went to the bar, her and her girlfriend, me and Bob, we had like a long talk and all like that, good time. But anyway, so I'm sitting there and I go to, I had an Aurora model kit, an original one, a Batman, you know, the original with the artwork, you know,
this one with the tree hanging off at the back. The one my father, my biggest memory was.
Yeah.
I broke it in the crib. My father fixed it for me when I was 3 years old.
So I'm sitting there. I throw it down in front of Adam. What's he doing? Autographs. He looks. He goes, I can't sign that. And I said, Mr. West, I'm not going to resell it. You could personalize it to me. I said, I'm a big fan. I said, I've been a big fan, or Batman fan, all most of my life. I said, I was there at Jersey City. At Journal Square, and you came late, and he looked at me like, "Well, I remember that."
Yeah.
He goes, "Okay, I'll sign it." So he signed it, you know. So Burt Ward's looking at me, he's going like this, and they had a thing. Burt Ward has to be 30 feet away from Adam West. They didn't like each other. They all did. They all the Batman people would congregate together, and Adam would be there by himself. And I see, and like he said some remark to me, and Julie Newmar was there. She went like. Like, oh, here he is again. You know, like, she was like, yeah. I said, what's going on here?
You met Julie Newmar?
Oh, yeah. But you know what Bob said to her? Thank you for getting me through puberty. She was really nice. And I met the other Catwoman, the one that was on the time tunnel. She was a Miss America. What's her name?
All I know is what's...
The one that was in the movie.
Lee Merriweather.
She was very nice.
She was beautiful.
She was very nice. And that's when I started I met Frank Gorshin at the show. And he was really, really nice to me. And I said to him, I said, you know, we were all talking. He had like a talk. We went, and I said to him, you know, you're really known for all your impression work. You do like Rich Little, you do like a lot of impressions. He goes, oh, yeah. He goes, I said, so remember you did Burt Lancaster? He kept doing Burt Lancaster for me. So years later, after I did Sabretooth, that guy gets, when I was in SAG, I got in SAG, they said, you got to have an agent. So they, because we were fighting with them. He goes, this is your agent now. So I went down to meet the woman and to be the agent and everything. And I see Adam West's agent in the office. And I go, oh, is that Bill? He goes, yeah, he's Adam West's. Yeah, he works here. So he worked for the same agent that was my Yeah, we're Frank Gorshin's agent. So I got, you know, and then I went out to eat with Rallis and Mark, and we're down in Hollywood, and I just see somebody tap me on the shoulder, goes, hey, Greg. And I turn around, and it's Frank Gorshin. he remembered my name. He goes, so you're going to eat here? Is this place good? Is this restaurant good? I said, I don't know. I said, I don't know. I said, I've never ate here before. He goes, well, why don't you come and hang out with us at the bar and stuff? He was really cool. Really, really cool.
He remembered
my name. He goes, hey, Greg, what are you doing here? I'm in LA now. Because I knew him from these shows. You know, I used to sell stuff. He signed my, I had a video box of a half black, half white, you know, the episode Star Trek. He signed it. And I found out from him, if you look at his performance in the first Batman TV show, it's half serious. He's like the best Riddler. He really is. And it's like, he didn't play it all. Camp. And the thing is, I found out he was a big Batman fan when he was a kid, and his favorite villain was the Riddler. And he said, when I got to play it, it was like a big thing for me. He was a nice guy. I told him, I said, I remember when you were on
the Did you come on the set of Monsters and talk to him too?
I talked to him there. I remember him. I didn't know him that well then. He knew me by sight.
So we did the creatures for that show.
I told him that. I said, I worked on Monsters. I remember that with Peggy Cass. And then he says to me, I said, I remember all your roles. I remember when you were in The Great Imposter with Tony Curtis. I said, I remember you in the... I mentioned a bunch of Westerns he was in. And then I said, you were on The Untouchables. I said, I remember my favorite role is your Fair Deal Dan on The Munsters when you sold Herman the bad car. He goes, he looked at me, he goes, how old are you?
Yeah.
He was a cool guy. Yeah.
Yeah, rest his soul.
Yeah. Very, very cool guy. And I remember briefly
met him on
Monsters. He was in the 12 Monkeys.
Because I was ahead of the creatures, and I bumped. And then Linda Blair was next door. I remember when I first met Linda Blair. I was at this meeting, and I'm talking to the director, and there's this girl sitting there, and I turn around, and I go, Jesus Christ. I said, you look just like Linda Blair. And she goes, you know, everybody tells me that. And I went, I go, oh, because you are Linda Blair. They all start laughing. I'm like, I feel like
I made her laugh at a party.
She's a big wild woman.
I was there with Mark Alford.
Love Dick.
And Bill Maher was there.
Do you know Rick James said the best sex he ever had
was with Linda Blair. She was cute when she was a kid. I'm at a party with, don't record this.
What?
Put it down.
This is cool stuff.
I'm at a party.